Hello everyone, today we will discuss oxidation number for class plus 1 under the chapter redox reaction. In last lecture we have discussed oxidation and reduction. Increase in oxidation number is oxidation and decrease in oxidation number is reduction. So now what is this oxidation number? Oxidation number is the charge present on any atom when it is in a combining state, when it is combining with any other element to form a compound. For example, we have sodium. Now this sodium has no charge. Why? Because it is in free state, it is not combining with any other atom or any other element to form a compound. But if we have sodium chloride, now it is a combination product of sodium and chlorine. So now charge present on sodium here is plus 1. Now this plus 1 is called oxidation number. Charge present on any atom when it is in a combining state. But if we have free elements like sodium, magnesium, aluminium, sulfur, phosphorus, now they are not combining with any other element. So their oxidation number is 0. So rule number first is oxidation number of free elements is always 0, but when they are combining with other elements, then the charge will present on atoms, that will call their oxidation number. There are some rules, we will understand every rule with a suitable example. Oxidation number of group 1 element is always plus 1. Oxidation number of group 2 element is always plus 2. Oxidation number of group number 13 element is always plus 3. The elements of group number 1 are first group elements are lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium. Group number 2 elements are beryllium, magnesium, calcium, strontium and barium. Group number 13 elements are boron, aluminium, gallium, indium and thallium. They always show constant oxidation number, specific oxidation number. Why? Group number 1 element contain only one valence electron. So after losing one electron, they show always plus 1 charge. Group number 2 contains two valence electrons. After losing two electrons, the oxidation state charge will come plus 2. And group number 13 contains three valence electrons. After losing all these three electrons, charge will be plus 3. This is rule number first. As we know, fluorine is the most electronegative element. It has a tendency to attract a bonded pair of electrons. That's why oxidation number of fluorine is always minus 1. No variation in oxidation number of fluorine. Always, it shows always a minus 1 charge, minus 1 oxidation state. Next is the sum total of all the charges present in any compound is always 0. All the charges present on atoms in any compound is always 0. Why? Because electric compounds are electrically neutral. The total negative charge will be equal to total of positive charge. फॉर एग्जाम्पल वी हैव पोटेशियम पर मैग्नेट एंड वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट द ऑक्सीडेशन नंबर ऑफ मैग्नीज। सो द चार्ज ऑफ पोटेशियम प्लस चार्ज ऑफ मैग्नीज प्लस चार्ज ऑफ ऑक्सीजन दैट विल बी इक्वल टू जीरो बिकॉज इट इज इलेक्ट्रिकली न्यूट्रल, नो चार्ज प्रेजेंट। सो इफ वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट द ऑक्सीडेशन नंबर ऑफ मैग्नीज, पोटेशियम ग्रुप नंबर वन एलिमेंट ऑलवेज प्लस वन, वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट द ऑक्सीडेशन नंबर ऑफ मैग्नीज, वी अज्यूम इट एक्स प्लस द चार्ज ऑन प्रेजेंट ऑन ऑक्सीजन इज माइनस टू बट वी हैव फोर एटम्स, टोटल चार्ज इज माइनस एट इक्वल टू जीरो, सो एक्स इक्वल टू प्लस सेवन। सो इफ वी हैव टू द फाइंड आउट द ऑक्सीडेशन नंबर ऑफ एनी पर्टिकुलर एटम इन ए गिवन कंपाउंड वी कैन यूज दिस मेथड। लेट्स सी वन मोर एग्जांपल। नाउ वी हैव पोटेशियम dichromate and we have to find out the oxidation number of chromium. Again, the sum total of all the charges present in a given compound is 0. So, plus 2. Now we have 2 atoms, so we assume it as 2x plus minus 14 equal to 0. 7 atoms, so total charge will be minus 14. 2x equal to plus 12, x equal to plus 6. So charge present on one chromium atom is plus 6, right? But in case of ions, that sum total of all the charges present in any ion is given or is always equal to the charge present on a ion. That is rule number 4. For ions, the sum total of all charges equal to the charge present on a ion. For example, we have sulfate ions and we have to find out the oxidation number of sulfur. So the charge of sulfur plus charge of oxygen is equal to minus 2. We have to find out for sulfur x. So the oxidation number of sulfur is plus 6. For ions, sum total is equal to charge present on ion. For compounds, sum total is equal to 0 because electric compounds are electrically neutral. Next is oxidation number of same element in different compound is a variable. No specific oxidation number. Oxidation number is variable from compound to compound for even same element. For example, we have few compounds of sulfur. All the compounds are of sulfur. Now we have to find out the oxidation number of sulfur. Here minus 2, here free state 0, here we can find out plus 2 plus x minus 4 equal to 0, x equal to plus 2, here x will be plus 4, here x will be plus 6. So same sulfur atom element is showing different oxidation states in a different compounds. That is the unique thing of oxidation number. Oxidation number for same element, oxidation number is variable. Right? Next rule is ऑक्सीडेशन नंबर ऑफ हाइड्रोजन इज ऑलवेज प्लस वन एक्सेप्ट मेटालिक हाइड्राइड. इफ हाइड्रोजन इज प्रेजेंट विद मेटल्स देन इट शोज माइनस वन ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल वी हैव दीज आर मेटालिक हाइड्राइड सोडियम हाइड्राइड मैग्नीशियम हाइड्राइड. चार्ज प्रेजेंट ऑन हाइड्रोजन इज हेयर माइनस वन. हेयर two atoms but on one atom we have a minus one charge. But for other hydrides, other compounds like we have NH3, charge present of hydrogen is a plus one. So nitrogen is minus three, hydrogen is a plus one, but we have three atoms, right? Next is a ऑक्सीडेशन नंबर कैन बी जीरो पॉजिटिव नेगेटिव एंड इवन फ्रैक्शनल ऑक्सीडेशन नंबर्स आर आल्सो देयर. लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड द पोटेशियम सुपर ऑक्साइड. चार्ज प्रेजेंट ऑन पोटेशियम इज प्लस वन. सो प्लस वन plus 2x equal to 0, x equal to minus 1 by 2. So oxidation number can be fractional also. So we can see oxidation number can be 0, can be fractional, can be positive, can be negative. Right, so by these rules we can find out the oxidation number, and by finding out the oxidation number we can find out is there any oxidation or a reduction in the reactions. Why? Because increase in oxidation number increase in oxidation number is reduction, and increase in oxidation number is oxidation. So we have to understand first what is oxidation number, right? That's for oxidation number. Thank you.